So you all can see that I have solved most of the hard questions in expert ones. So let's begin with matrix layer rotation. Matrix layer rotation one. So what it has actually. Now what you have to do in this one is, you have been given a 2D matrix of M is to N. Okay. Now, a positive integer R would also be provided. You have to rotate the matrix R times and print the resultant matrix rotation should be in anti-clockwise direction. Okay. For example, they have shown it in the diagram that if you rotate it in the anti-clockwise direction, then A of 1 by 5 will come at the place of A of 1 4, and so on. 1 2 will come at 1 1. 1 1 will come to 2 1. 2 1 3 1, and so on. Okay. So it is guaranteed that minimum of M and N will be even. Okay. An example, rotate the start matrix by 2. Now you have been given a matrix, you have to rotate by 2. The very first thing that will happen, 2 will come in place of 1, 1 will go in the place of 12 and then down, and then 10 will shift right and so on. Okay, and even the inner one, this 1, 2, 3, 4 will also be shifted. 2 will come in place of 1, 1 down, 4 here and so. And again the same thing. So this will be our resultant matrix. Now we have to think how we can implement this thing. Now let's see what all we have to do. Input format will be M, N, R. Okay. And the next line, next M lines and N spaced characters. So this will be a matrix followed by it. So M and R is being given to be 4, 4, 2. Okay, then 1 2 3 4 4 4, this is 4 by 4 matrix. So 4 rows and 4 columns matrix has been given to you, and you have to do 2 rotations. So with 2 rotations, 3 will come in place of 1, 1 will go in place of 9, and they will shift by 2 to positions each. So you have been given this. Now let's see what we could doing this. So first we'll import all the packages available. Then under the class shell, this is a class solution, and then class shell, we'll accept the rows and columns. Now the very first thing we have to do in main is accept M and R. That would be a first input. Okay, now we'll take a matrix of M is to N. And then we'll also declare a rotated matrix, which we'll fill after rotations. Number of layers is mat.min n, m divided by 2. So how many layers could be formed, inner, outer, all considering, we'll find it out through this. Int I equals to 0, I less than number of layers, I plus plus. Now, row lower limit, row upper limit, column lower limit and column upper limit. All of this we can find. Path length is n minus I into 2 into 2 plus m minus I into 2 into 2. This will give us the path length. Now I'll create an array list, namely path. In current row position, I'll put it I, and current column index will also be I. Down, right, up, left. I'll define this as the Boolean characters and give them some values, true, false, respectively. Now, we'll add the new cells like current and check them. Whether are they equal, then down should be false and right should be true. Second condition, if current row index is equals to current upper limit and current column index equals to column upper limit, this is to check whether we are at the extreme positions and we don't try to move up, or we don't try to move down when you are at the lowest position. and whether you are at the rightmost, you don't try to move to the right further. Okay, so we'll meet conditions like this. Now, if down, we'll increase the row index by 1. If right, we'll increase the column index by 1. And if up, we'll decrease it by 1. And for left also, the column will be decreases by 1. Finally, when we are done, so we have done a lot of motion with it, we'll finally get it through path.get as it was analyzed. Now, new cell path get I equals to 0, I less than M, and directly we print it up. It's quite complicated if you see, because it's a hard one, so you need to know how you have to form the layers. The very first thing is forming the layers one, the minimum layers you need, and then how to identify the extreme positions. If extreme position is there, you'll make it false, and then you'll check whether that condition was true or false. Okay, this was just a rough explanation of this question. I would like all of you to try it once with yourself. If you don't get, I will have a detailed discussion on this question for sure. And if you want to get my code, want to review it, click on the link given in the description. Surely you will get it. Thank you. But before that, please click the like, share, subscribe.